quantum mechanics is based on standard mathematical methods and their physically meaningful extensions. In particular, we will utilize techniques from three different areas. These are complex numbers, functions and calculus, and vectors and matrices. We will look at the details whenever we need them, but for preparation, I've here collected a few basic concepts. We start with complex numbers, whose natural appearance is a key feature of quantum mechanics. These numbers are composed out of two real numbers, x and y, and the imaginary unit I. X is known as the real part and y as the imaginary part, and together these numbers span the so-called complex plane, where x determines the position along the so-called real axis and y determines the position along the so-called imaginary axis. For algebraic calculations, you just need to know a single additional rule, namely that I squares to minus 1, which is indeed the definition of the imaginary unit. With this, you can then, for instance, multiply two complex numbers, such as a plus ib and x plus iy, and the result is just another complex number. And you can also divide, for instance, calculate the inverse of a complex number. In the result, you find in the numerator the original complex number, but with I replaced by minus I. This is known as the complex conjugated number. In the denominator, you find the square of the length of the number in the complex plane, which we call the absolute value. In the complex plane, the complex conjugated number is found by a simple reflection with respect to the real axis. Using polar coordinates, we can rewrite a complex number in terms of its absolute value and the angle phi. And as it happens, the combination of the two trigonometric functions that appear here can be rewritten as a complex exponential function. This is the famous Euler identity, which will be extremely useful both for the description of quantum systems as well as in our calculations. For example, the complex conjugated number can again be obtained from this expression by replacing I by minus I. And using the rules of multiplication of exponentials, we see that the absolute value squared of a complex number is obtained by multiplying it by its complex conjugate. These features lead us smoothly on to functions and calculus. The trigonometric functions sine and cosine are central for the descriptions of waves. Indeed, as a function of position x, they describe plane waves. And by Euler's identity, we can again combine them into a complex exponential, which is indeed the precise form of the most simplest waves in quantum mechanics. But we will also encounter the exponential function in other contexts, with real exponents, or even in the form of a so-called Gaussian, which is the bell-shaped curve sketched here. And of course, these functions also appear with other arguments in place of x, such as t for time. Now, using the basic rules of calculus, such as the product and the chain rule, we can calculate derivatives of such functions, such as the ones shown here. And we will also calculate integrals, both indefinite and definite ones. The first integral given here we would just write down, but when it comes to the second one, I will show you a brief derivation. For detailed calculations, it is also useful to know about power series and their relation, say, to Taylor expansions, but this mainly serves as a backdrop for certain types of polynomials, known as orthogonal polynomials, that we will encounter in some very specific settings, and we will simply introduce these polynomials when we need them. So for us, such functions and calculus are mainly tools to describe quantum systems and to carry out some calculations. Just as complex numbers, vectors and matrices appear very naturally in quantum mechanics, hence are intimately tied to the mathematical structure of this theory. We will encounter vectors both in very specific forms, such as a column vector with n components, and also written more generally, say with basis vectors, denoted here as en. And we will carry out standard operations on these vectors, such as adding them up or multiplying them by a scalar. The matrices that we will encounter are square matrices with equal numbers of components in both directions. And using the standard rule of matrix multiplication, the product of such a matrix by a vector gives another vector with the same number of components. And we will also encounter products between two vectors, very similar to the familiar dot product. Such rules become applicable to quantum mechanics when we make some suitable adaptations by taking care of the complex numbers that can appear in such vectors and reflecting this in a useful notation, the Dirac notation, which facilitates the calculations. Throughout the course, we will see how far-reaching these generalizations really are. For instance, we will be able to replace vectors by functions and matrices by suitable mathematical operations. And we will also learn more about the specific properties of vectors and matrices that appear in quantum mechanics. We will also make use of one more way to tie vectors and matrices together. This relates to the fact that for any given matrix A, there are very special vectors that, when multiplied by the matrix, do not change their direction, but are simply scaled in length by a certain scale factor that I here denote as lambda. These vectors are known as the eigenvectors of the matrix, and the scale factors are known as the eigenvalues. In quantum mechanics, these mathematical objects acquire a surprisingly concrete, physical meaning that is indeed a central element of this theory. If all these mathematical elements mentioned here feel familiar, great, this will be really helpful. And if some of this is unfamiliar, these methods all have applications far beyond quantum mechanics, and so are definitely worthwhile studying in their own right, and you will be able to find many useful resources on these topics. But even more, quantum mechanics is also a wonderful place to get some working practice with these techniques, even if you've picked them up just for this purpose.